Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Nikki. Thank you for stopping by. So today's pour is on this 20 by 24 canvas, and it's just a nice straight pour, nothing super fancy, but I think the color palette was really nice. And that vermilion color is a really nice color. It's not too orangey to the point that you can't work with it. Like, I really struggle with working with oranges and reds. But there's just something about that vermilion that just works really great with, like, turquoise colors, seafoam greens, those sort of colors. It just works really great with it. So, yeah, that's probably one of my favorite, like, orangey red colors. And that's saying a lot because I don't like orange or red, to be honest. Today's video is pretty short, and that's just because this is a very simple technique. This is the most basic type of technique you can do. You just layer your colors and pour it straight onto the canvas. The only kind of technique to it is just that I was, varying the height of the cup from the canvas, so I would raise it and lower it, and this just causes the paint to flow more heavily or less so. But yeah, that was pretty much the only type of technique that I practiced. It does have the ultra bright metallic in it. I think I used the aquamarine, so that did create some cells, which was really nice. I also used that fire opal in it from the Folk Art Treasure Gold line. Y'all, it is so, I cannot get over how incredibly beautiful that paint is. It's almost duochrome. Like, when you mix it, you can see it's almost got a purple reflex in it. It's incredible, and I really, really love that. That's my favorite color from the Treasure Gold line is that fire opal. It's just, y'all, I would say if you were only going to get one color from that line, I would get the fire opal because it's the most unique in my opinion. They're expensive, though. That's all I can say. I complain about how pricey they are every time I use them because I think it's ridiculous how much those paints cost. I don't think they're very, I don't think they're geared for paint pouring, obviously, because of the price point, but you can use them sparingly, and I guess, it'll be okay. It has to be okay, right? It's like we have two options. Take it or leave it. That's the two options we have when it comes to the price point of those. But thankfully, Michael's does run sales. So, that is nice. But I am letting this puddle sit for a minute to kind of develop those cells that will come up because of the ultra bright metallic. I did leave these paints slightly thicker. One of my beautiful subscribers reminded me that on my last video I was talking about I can't make it do like Sarah Mac does. And she reminded me Sarah Mac's paints were thicker. And I was like, oh yeah, you know what? You're right. You're right. They are thicker. So I left these a little thicker. It's a challenge to go from thinner consistency paints to these thicker paints. They flow differently, obviously, with the consistency being quite different. It's just a different flow. And I did not compensate for the difference in that. And so I got a little bit worried this last corner. Like, am I overstretching? Because I could start to see the lines start to kind of wiggle. And I'm like, I'm fixing to overstretch the mess out of this piece and I'm going to be so upset. But it has dried since I poured it, and it actually came out okay. I think that the thinner white paint that I put down around it really helped it, but if I were to do it again, I would put probably about 1.5 or 2 ounces more of paint, because I don't like for my lines to look squiggly like they do in that corner closest, the left-hand corner closest to me. I don't know how to explain it, but those blues, they're looking a little squiggly. I'm not crazy about that. But other than that, I love this color palette. I think it looks great. Yeah, and it dried beautifully as well. So this is it. These are the wet results. And then here are the dried results. So it did dry darker than it was wet. But I think that it came out really, really great. And I really love it. So yeah. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this. Hope you're staying healthy and safe wherever you are. And I will speak with you all very soon. Bye.